Big yay for the iPad mini. I already have tons of videos out on this channel on the new iPad mini that I will be sure to link in the description so you can check them out. But first, today's video. So it's obviously no question, unless you're new to the channel, and if you are, welcome, that I create tons of videos on digital planning and creative content that you can do on the iPad. I know how important digital planning is to not only me, but to a lot of you, and so I wanted to dedicate a video to digital planning on the new iPad mini. I already have a digital planning video out on the iPad 9th generation that I'll have linked in the description, but in today's video, we'll focus on the new iPad mini. Now, a lot of people will see the iPad mini as a consumption device. This device that's really great and really portable for playing games or reading books, web browsing, as well as staying connected with your friends and family either through FaceTime or voice and video chat. But the iPad mini is also a really great reference tool. Now with it being more portable compared to other iPads like the iPad Air or the iPad Pro, and even the iPad 9th generation. Now you might not think that the iPad mini would be a great iPad for things like digital planning, and I will be the first to tell you that I am so in love and am so obsessed with my super large 12.9 inch iPad Pro from this year, but I love my iPad mini for all the reasons I'm not using my iPad Pro, and that is consumption and as a reference tool. So I have started playing really cool games on my iPad mini and indulging a bit more on social media just for fun. And I include other ways that I like to use the iPad mini in one of my past videos that are linked in the description. But I also really like using the iPad mini as a reference tool like I previously mentioned. And that's something that I didn't normally use my iPad Pro for. So because the apps that I use are pretty awesome and Apple reviews apps before they go live on the App Store, a lot of apps will adapt to the screen that they're on. So if I'm on the iPad Pro, my GoodNotes app, for instance, will fit the screen really well of my iPad mini. That's not to say that all apps are like this, but most of the ones that I use are. The same thing goes for digital planners and digital notebooks. So whatever the digital planner looks like on an iPad Pro, for instance, it will look the exact same on an iPad mini, albeit smaller. When I was digital planning on my iPad Pro, it honestly felt the same as it did whenever I was digital planning on my iPad mini. I didn't deviate from my normal planning schedule. I still used split screen on my iPad mini. I still used fonts. I still took handwritten notes or wrote things down like appointments and due dates. Still use stickers. So whatever you can do on the iPad Pro, you can still do on the iPad mini as far as digital planning goes. The one thing that is different about digital planning on the iPad mini is the increased portability due to the smaller size of the iPad mini. To be honest, I never had an issue taking my iPad Pro anywhere. My handbag is on the smaller side, so I couldn't fit as many things in it if I did bring my Pro, and I did have to kind of put my iPad Pro in my bag upright, but I could make it work. It did honestly get kind of heavy with my iPad Pro in there though, so that's where the iPad mini comes in. The iPad mini makes it easier and safer, to be honest, and also just more enjoyable to carry around in my handbag, my purse, whatever. For instance, it's easier to head out and just chill out on this massively huge rock out by where I live, write out my plans, take pictures of my surroundings, head out into the grocery store and check off things on my grocery list. It's not that big of a deal to whip out the iPad mini. It's not as noticeable, it's not as clunky, it's not as heavy. Digital planning has already been such a huge part of my life, and it introduced me to you and this channel. It's quite literally how I got started and how I'm here now. And as much as I love digital planning on my large display on the iPad Pro, I feel like having the iPad mini introduces a new and unique way of digital planning. And I honestly feel like I'm more likely and more often to digitally plan because I can just whip it out in weird locations and plan. It is being introduced into my life more because I can go anywhere with my iPad mini, which holds all of my digital planners, all of my fonts, and just all the fun stuff. But I am interested in hearing your thoughts. What do you think about digital planning and the iPad mini? Did you purchase an iPad mini? leave them in the comments and I'll be sure to read them and try and get back to you. Whenever I'm not here on YouTube, I am over there on Instagram hanging out and chatting with you all, so be sure to follow me over there at K Digital Studio. Thanks as always for watching my videos and being here with me on the channel. It really means the world to me. Thank you so much, and I'll be sure to see you in the next video here. Bye everyone.